Hello, science fans! Today, we're about to embark on a journey through time and nature, exploring a creature that's been quietly shaping the world for millions of years, often right under our noses. That's right, we're talking about the mosquito, one of the oldest and most resilient insects on Earth. Despite their tiny size, mosquitoes have a massive story to tell. Fossils show that mosquitoes have been around since the time of the dinosaurs, surviving for over 50 million years. Imagine that. These little insects have witnessed the rise and fall of some of the planet's most legendary creatures. Picture a massive T-Rex stomping through a steamy prehistoric swamp, while clouds of mosquitoes buzzed nearby, just as they do today. It's a wild thought, but it's true. Mosquitoes have been a constant presence through dramatic changes in Earth's history. Over millions of years, mosquitoes have adapted to almost every environment on the planet. From steamy jungles and humid wetlands to dry grasslands and even bustling cities, they've found ways to survive and thrive everywhere except Antarctica. With more than 3,000 known species, mosquitoes are true masters of adaptation. All they need is a small patch of standing water, like a puddle, a pond, or even a forgotten flower pot, to lay their eggs and start the next generation. Their ability to adjust to new environments, climates, and even human activity is a big reason why they've survived for so long. Whether it's a rainforest, a city park, or a backyard, mosquitoes find a way to make it home. The next time you hear that high-pitched buzz near your ear, remember, it's not just an annoyance, it's the echo of millions of years of evolution, a sound that's been heard by creatures from the age of dinosaurs to the present day. Mosquitoes have managed to outlast the dinosaurs, survive ice ages, and spread to every continent except the frozen lands of Antarctica. Their journey across the globe is nothing short of remarkable for such a small, delicate creature. Scientists are fascinated by mosquitoes not just because of their long history, but also because of their impact on ecosystems and even human health. They play a role in food webs, pollinate certain plants, and are a subject of ongoing research. From the murky swamps of the ancient world to the green lawns of our modern neighborhoods, mosquitoes are a living link to the distant past. They connect us to a time when giant reptiles ruled the earth. And they're not done yet. Mosquitoes continue to evolve, adapting to new challenges and changing environments right alongside us. Their story is still being written. So the next time you swat at a mosquito, take a moment to appreciate the incredible journey that brought it to your backyard. You're not just brushing away a pest, you're coming face to face with a tiny survivor from Earth's ancient history. Not every mosquito is out to bite you. In fact, the vast majority of mosquitoes you see buzzing around are not interested in your blood at all. It's a common misconception that all mosquitoes are little vampires, but the truth is much more fascinating. Only female mosquitoes need blood, while males stick to flower nectar. Males spend their days sipping on sweet plant juices, completely ignoring humans and animals. Females, however, are driven by a unique biological need that sets them apart. Males have bushy, feathery antennae to detect the high-pitched buzz of females, while females have simpler antennae. These differences aren't just for show, they help each mosquito find what it needs most. Males use their sensitive antennae to locate mates, while females are equipped to seek out hosts for blood meals. The reason for this difference? Eggs. Females need the nutrients in blood to develop their eggs. Blood is packed with proteins and iron, which are essential for producing healthy offspring. Without a blood meal, a female mosquito simply can't lay viable eggs. Males live short, simple lives, just long enough to mate. Their main purpose is to find a female, reproduce, and then their role in the mosquito world is complete. They rarely live more than a week or two. Females, on the other hand, are on a mission to create the next generation. After mating, a female will seek out a blood meal, find a safe place to lay her eggs, often in standing water, and then repeat the cycle several times in her life. This cycle is crucial for the survival of mosquito populations. Each female can lay hundreds of eggs, ensuring the species continues to thrive, even in challenging environments. So, if a mosquito lands on you, it's a mother-to-be, not a random attacker. She's following instincts honed over millions of years, all for the sake of her future offspring. Her bite is a necessary step in the circle of life. While it may be annoying for us, it's a vital process for her species' survival. Every bite helps her gather the nutrients she needs to lay eggs, and each new generation starts the cycle all over again. This division of labor leads to very different behaviors and traits between male and female mosquitoes. Males are gentle pollinators, while females are the determined hunters, each playing a unique role in the ecosystem. Next time you get bitten, remember, it's all about survival and reproduction. Science is cool. Understanding these tiny creatures helps us appreciate the complexity of nature, even when it itches. And now you know who's really after you. Let's move on to uncover more secrets of the insect world. How do mosquitoes find you in a crowd? They're expert hunters, using a mix of senses. First, they smell the carbon dioxide you breathe out from up to 75 feet away. As they get closer, they sense your body heat and spot your movement. Their tiny hairs feel air currents you create, guiding them in for a landing. It's a multi-step process: smell, heat, sight, and touch, all working together. That's why it's so hard to hide from a determined mosquito. Even in the dark, they can track you down. Mosquitoes are tiny, but their hunting skills are top-notch. Nature's little bloodhounds. A mosquito bite is actually a precise, complex operation. Her mouth, the proboscis, is made of 6 tiny needles, each with a special job. 2 saw through your skin, 2 hold it open, and the last 2 inject saliva and draw blood. The sheath folds back, letting the needles work like a surgeon's toolkit. This design is so effective, it's inspired new medical needles. The mosquito's saliva numbs the area, so you barely feel a thing. She searches for a blood vessel, then drinks for up to 3 minutes if undisturbed. It's a marvel of microengineering, perfected over millions of years. Next time you itch, remember the tiny, sophisticated machinery at work. Even the smallest creatures can be master engineers. That's evolution in action. Let's see what's in that mosquito spit. Onward. Before drinking, a mosquito injects her saliva, a mix of over 100 proteins and enzymes, into your skin. Her spit contains anticoagulants to keep your blood flowing, and anesthetics to numb the area. That's why you often don't feel the bite right away. If you did, you'd swat her before she finished. The itch comes later, thanks to your immune system reacting to her saliva. Your body releases histamine, causing swelling and that familiar itch. So, the bite isn't what itches. It's your body's defense against her spit. Mosquito saliva is a tiny chemical toolkit for a successful meal. It's a brilliant evolutionary trick. Next time you scratch, remember, it's your body fighting back. Mosquitoes are sneaky, but your immune system is sneakier. Let's see why that blood meal matters so much. Why do female mosquitoes need blood? It's all about making eggs. Nectar gives them energy, but only blood has the protein and iron needed for egg development. Without blood, most females can't lay eggs at all. After feeding, she rests and digests, then produces up to 200 eggs at a time. She'll repeat this cycle, feed, rest, lay eggs, several times in her life. Each blood meal is a step toward hundreds of new mosquitoes. That's why they're so persistent. Controlling mosquitoes means breaking this cycle. It's a relentless drive for survival and family. Now let's follow the next generation. A mosquito's life begins in the most unassuming places, anywhere water collects and sits undisturbed. It could be a large pond shimmering in the sunlight, a muddy puddle after a rainstorm, or even something as small as a forgotten bottle cap filled with rainwater in your backyard. These tiny pools become nurseries for one of the world's most persistent pests. After taking a blood meal, the female mosquito seeks out these watery havens. She carefully lays her eggs, sometimes hundreds at a time, on the surface of the water or on damp soil nearby. Each egg is a potential new mosquito, waiting for the right conditions to hatch. When the eggs hatch, out come the larvae, often called wrigglers for the way they dart and squirm through the water. These tiny creatures breathe through a snorkel-like tube at their tail end, coming up to the surface for air. They feed on microscopic debris, algae, and organic matter, growing rapidly as they prepare for their next transformation. Over the course of several days, the larvae molt 4 times, shedding their skins as they grow. Each molt brings them closer to the next stage, the pupa, or tumbler. In this form, they stop feeding and begin an incredible transformation, developing the features of an adult mosquito. The pupal stage is brief, lasting just a couple of days. Inside the protective casing, the mosquito changes dramatically, preparing for life above the water. Finally, the adult mosquito emerges, breaking free from the pupal case and resting on the water's surface as its wings dry. Within moments, it's ready to take flight, beginning the cycle anew. Male mosquitoes, with their feathery antennae, live only about 2 weeks. Their main purpose is to find a mate, and they spend their short lives swarming and searching for females. Female mosquitoes, on the other hand, can live up to 2 months. During this time, they feed on blood to nourish their eggs and can lay several batches, each containing dozens or even hundreds of eggs. This makes them especially effective at multiplying quickly. Under the right conditions, the entire mosquito life cycle, from egg to adult, can be completed in as little as a week or two. This rapid development means that mosquito populations can surge almost overnight, especially after rain. That's why, when the weather is warm and wet, you might suddenly notice swarms of mosquitoes appearing seemingly out of nowhere. Their numbers can explode, making them a nuisance and a health risk. The best way to stop this cycle is simple. Remove standing water wherever you find it. By emptying buckets, cleaning gutters, and getting rid of puddles, you can prevent mosquitoes from breeding right in your own backyard. From a single puddle to a backyard full of pests, the transformation is astonishingly fast. Mosquitoes are experts at turning even the smallest bit of water into a thriving habitat. But do mosquitoes bite everyone equally, or do they have favorites? Let's find out what makes some people more attractive to these tiny, persistent pests. If you're enjoying this video, smash the like button and subscribe to the channel for more fascinating science stories. Ever notice some people get bitten more than others? Mosquitoes do have favorites. Most species prefer animals like birds or reptiles, but a few target humans. Your scent, body temperature, and even blood type can make you more attractive. Some people produce more chemicals like lactic acid, drawing mosquitoes in. Amazingly, mosquitoes can learn and remember scents. If you swat at them, they may avoid you next time. So, your actions can teach mosquitoes to stay away. It's not just about your smell, but how you react. Swatting might actually help. Mosquitoes are smarter than you think. Science is everywhere. How can you keep mosquitoes at bay? Use science. Repellents like DEET or picaridin block their sense of smell, making you invisible to them. Mosquito traps use carbon dioxide and heat to lure and capture them. The best defense? Eliminate standing water where they breed. Check your yard for puddles, bird baths, and clogged gutters. Empty them regularly. Wear long sleeves and pants, especially at dawn and dusk. Use window screens and mosquito nets for extra protection. Combine these strategies for a no-bite zone. With a little effort, you can outsmart our ancient buzzing neighbors. Enjoy the outdoors mosquito-free. Science wins again.